Welcome to JSC's Flying, and very good news, the new version of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher makes the Mac Pro and many other unsupported Mac hardware Monterey ready. So the newest version of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher from Dortania has some features many of you might have been waiting for months and years. So if you go to the Legacy Patcher homepage and click in started to building and install OpenCore, and you click on the link Legacy Patcher releases, you find the latest release 0.2.5. So what are the features that makes me so amazed about this release? They already say here, this release is one of our biggest yet, including many long awaited features and fixes. So at least for Mac Pro users, the best thing here is Wi-Fi and Bluetooth support for legacy chipsets in Monterey. Even if you have upgraded your Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module, like you can see here in my video, to a newer version, when you try to install Monterey, the macOS 12 beta, the installer will say, please connect a keyboard and a mouse. And you only can proceed when you have a USB wired keyboard and wired mouse to the installer to install Monterey and to use it. Why? Apple dropped some drivers for the legacy chipsets, and Dortania and the Legacy Patcher bring them back into the open core. The next great thing for all you guys using a MacBook, MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, whatever, is non-metal acceleration for Monterey. So all the Mac hardware with graphic cards that are not metal capable can be used with Monterey and Big Sur. Let's get into the changelog details to check which chipsets are supported. And for the non-metal Monterey acceleration, Intel Iron Lake, Sandy Bridge, NVIDIA Tesla, and AMD TerraScale 1 and 2 are supported. So you can use your Mac hardware if they have such graphic chipsets with Monterey. And when you go down a little bit, you will find here what I already told you about, the legacy wireless and legacy Bluetooth support for the chipsets, BCMs. You can check if your chipset is in there, or just try to make a bootable USB drive and try to install the Monterey beta. If the installer comes up and your mouse and keyboard works, thanks Dortania for the fixes. Another cool feature is the offline TUI build. That means the text-based user interface. So your device where you want to install OpenCore doesn't have to be connected to the internet anymore, because normally it would download the latest version. Now here you have the feature of an offline build that you can just put on a USB drive, plug into the device that you want to patch, and it works. But for Mac Pro users, the best feature you just find here in the changelog up here. They said the iMac Pro 1.1SM BIOS for the Mac Pro and XSERF, that are the server versions. What does that mean? Normally, when you have an unsupported Mac hardware, and you go here to the Apple and click about this Mac, and then you click software update, as it's an unsupported model, it would say no update found. To get updates, you could spoof an official supported model like the Mac Pro 6.1 or 7.1, but then here in your overview, it would say not Mac Pro 2012, what it really is, it would say Mac Pro 2019, for instance, if you're using a Mac Pro 7.1. And if you spoof your Mac Pro, you lose half your CPU power. So I would suggest, by the way, if you haven't yet, you subscribe my channel and click the bell for notifications, but you don't need it to do anymore, because here the SM BIOS from the iMac Pro, which is still officially supported, is integrated in the OpenCore bootloader. And so, even though it shows up as a Mac Pro 2012, it gets all updates that are normally for the iMac Pro 1.1. Nice feature of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. So it just shows the correct hardware. There's no degradation in the CPU power, but all updates come smooth and regularly as if you would have supported hardware. Thank you for watching and see you soon in my next video. Don't forget to subscribe about the benchmarks of the Mac Pro 5.1 from 2012 and how spoofing degrades your CPU power in half. See you soon.